Hey guys, this is my Rayman Origins for the PS Vita review and gameplay video. Sorry, we'll just get right into it. This is your main page, and you can either choose ghost mode or GIFs or whatever. I'm using this little stylus that I've got, can't really see it properly, but got it for free, and it's actually really useful if you don't want to get your screen greasy or whatever, because I find that a bit annoying sometimes. So we're just going to jump into some random game. And I'll show you some gameplay, and while I'm doing that, I'll just talk about it. So, you can see here, I've unlocked 4 of the 5. It looks like there's 5 places. This is just your main where you can choose characters, something like that. I haven't played this game that much. You can see at the top there, it's only got 83 of like 200 and something, and 3 out of 10. So, I haven't played this game that much. I don't know how far I'm through it. I'm just going back and getting all the little pink smiley thingies, whatever. I'm trying to get them all and collect them all so I can actually complete this game properly. So, I'm not actually sure how far I've gotten through it, but what I've done so far, it's a really good game. It's actually on the PS3. I haven't tried it on the PS3, but apparently it's better on this, on your Vita. So, if you do have a Vita, then buy it. Yeah, if you don't have a Vita, of course, just get it on your PS3 anyway. It's just better on a Vita for some reason. I don't know why. Because I haven't actually played it. This is what my friend says. So, we'll jump into a level. I'll go this one. Okay. So, touchscreen isn't really... you can use it. It's not used that much. But you can collect the little gold collecting thingies. Those little flying bug things, whatever they are. Does it tell you here? Yeah, the yellow... lazy yellow fellas, whatever you want to call them. If they're in a bubble, you can tap the bubble with your... touch a screen, like there's one. I can just touch it there and I collect it, so... that's pretty much the only touchscreen there is. Plus, you can, when you're choosing your levels or whatever, you can use touchscreen. So this is the view that the whole game has. Throughout the whole thing, you do have there are some levels where it's silhouette, but that's not too difficult. These things, and there's these big coin things, and to collect them, you have to hold on to it without getting hurt for a certain amount of time, and then you actually get it and things like that. Use L1 or R1, L or R buttons to left and right buttons to sprint. And things like that. So yeah, it's not a bad game. Out of 10, I'd probably give it a 9, or 8 or 9. It's I wouldn't call it addictive, but it really gets you to think and play. It's really fun to play, and you really want to play it quite a bit, but I wouldn't... oh, I'm about to die. But I wouldn't call it addictive. I wasn't always wanting to pick it up and play it constantly or anything like that. But I did want to play it because it is a fun game. So yeah, I do recommend you buy it though. Don't know. Oh, my stupid phone's not focusing properly. There we go. Okay, the graphics are actually pretty good for a handheld. They're the same for the PS3, so I wouldn't complain about the graphics too much. I don't know if it's the same as PS3. I'm assuming it'll be the same, because these aren't high-end graphics or anything like that. I think they've done it deliberately, because Rayman's always been a not very high-end graphics game or anything like that, so I think they've tried to keep that in perspective for everyone. That's just how they make their games. It's kind of like Borderlands. Borderlands, good graphics, but they've deliberately made it a little bit cartoonish. I kind of like that. So yeah, what else can I say? This game does take a while to complete. If you want to get everything, get all the trophies. I haven't gotten all the trophies. I'm not actually sure how many I have. Maybe at the end of this video, I'll quickly check and I'll tell you guys. But yeah, I'm trying my best to get quite a few. Every now and then, when I think there aren't any to collect, any trophies to get, I just randomly get a trophy, and I'm just surprised. I don't even know how I did it. So trophies are you just get them randomly, really, for random things you do. You do get one each time you collect a power, like this flying one, punching, swimming, So there's a few powers that you can have. I don't know what the next one is because I haven't actually unlocked it yet, so sorry. There's little hidden parts like this, and you can collect coins like that, or there's other things you can collect. There's little hidden areas that you have to do, and you can get more points and things like that. So lots of hidden places in this game. It's a really good game. Yeah, I don't know what else to say about it really. If you do like these sort of games, sorry, I just died. If you do like these sort of games where you have this view and you like puzzles and things like that, this, well, I don't really know, but I wouldn't ever say puzzle, but like this kind of game. I don't really know what kind of game this is. If you like adventure games, there we go. If you like adventure games, and this is definitely a game for you guys. I would recommend buying it. I think it's $68 at EB Game Store. I'm not sure how much at JB Hi-Fi or anything like that. They should have them in stock. But the best place to go to buy a game is probably Harvey Norman, and you just talk to them, ask them if you can get it cheaper for what it actually is, and they can probably give it to you for like $10 off. I know I got my Harry Potter for $6 off because my friend works there, and he told me that there's pretty much no such thing as a set price or anything like that, because you can always get something for cheaper than what it actually is. So just hunt around, guys, and you can definitely get it for cheaper than what you see. Just talk to them, say, can you get this to me cheaper or something like that. It is a game I would recommend buying. My friend actually wants it back because he likes it. He kind of misses it. So, I just died again. Good one. So, yeah, guys, I recommend you buying it. It's a good game. This is pretty much all the game is. There's lots of different levels, and they come with all sorts of different challenges and things like that. The challenge in this one really is just those things in the water that keep on biting you. And these things turn into, like, random red birds. You get lots of different... I'm not watching. You get lots of different monsters and things like that, so it's a good challenge. It gets harder and harder to get to complete each level 100% as you go along. So it's a good challenge if you like challenges. So yeah, if you like a good challenge, buy the game. Out of 10, like I said, I'd probably give it an 8 or 9. Okay, I'm just not going to be able to do this. So so out of 10, I'd give it an 8 or a 9. Tell your friends and everything like that about my channel, please, because, in my feed, I mentioned I'll be doing PS Vita accessory giveaways or something like that, so I might give away a charging dock or something, I don't know, maybe covers and things like that. So, Once I hit 1,000 subscribers, I'll start doing giveaways every 1,000 subscribers I get. So just tell your friends, and you'll be in the chance to win. I haven't actually figured out a way that I can give it away. What I'll get you guys to do or anything like that. So yeah, once I figure out what I can do, then you guys just just stay tuned. I'll give you more details later on. Just remember to talk to your friends, get them to subscribe, and you could possibly win some accessories later on. When I get lots of subscribers, I'll start giving away games as well. So yeah, just stay tuned, tell your friends, subscribe, and I'll start posting more videos later on. This weekend I'll have Uncharted review and gameplay. I'll be doing a blog soon as well, so yeah, just stay tuned, guys, and I'll see you later. Okay, see ya, bye, guys.